Hey guys, it's Matt here, and in today's video, we're going to talk about iPad. Ever since Apple announced its latest 7th generation iPad, deciding which iPad to buy has been more confusing than ever. Apple's iPad lineup now includes the iPad mini, 7th generation iPad, iPad Air, 3rd generation, and the iPad Pros. All of which feature support for the Apple Pencil, as well as, with the exception of the iPad mini, the smart keyboard connector. To get the cheapest of Apple's latest iPads, you'd have to spend a minimum of $329. But what if I could tell you that you could get an iPad that's just as good, if not better in some ways, than Apple's cheapest entry-level iPad? Well, it turns out you can, and that's what we're going to talk about today. So the iPad in question is the 9.7-inch iPad Pro. Now, this was Apple's first generation of iPad Pros. They were launched in 2015 and 16, with the 12.9-inch launching in November of 15 and the iPad Pro 9.7-inch launching in March of 2016. So how does an iPad going on 4 years old this spring compare to something that just came out in September of 2019? Well, that's a good question, and the answer is surprisingly well. As I mentioned at the start of this video, this iPad is just as good in many ways, and if not even better in some other ways, than the iPad 7th generation, making it a very compelling value to buy in 2020. Now, one thing we do need to clear up before we go any further is pricing and availability. Part of buying an older device is the fact that you're going to have to deal with buying one pre-owned, and dealing with limited availability and pricing, specifically when it comes to maybe the color you want, the storage size you want, and whether it has cellular capability or not. Because they're not being produced anymore, you can't really just buy the one you want, you do have to do some digging. I purchased my 32GB iPad Pro in gold with Wi-Fi back in December of 2018, well after they've discontinued production of it. But I was able to get it for $250. It's also worth noting that prices can fluctuate depending on condition, and like I said before, cellular capability and storage size. On eBay, this iPad can currently be found for anywhere from the mid $100 range to the high $200 range. That said, all of those prices are still significantly lower than the $329 starting price for the 7th generation iPad that Apple is selling today. Moving on to features though, this is where the iPad Pro's value really shines brighter than the 7th generation iPads. There are four major kind of areas that I'd like to talk about, and the first is the display. Both the 7th generation iPad and the iPad Pro feature big, bright, and sharp retina displays. The iPad 7th generation's display comes in at 10.2 inches, and the iPad Pro's display comes in at 9.7 inches. But despite being larger, the iPad 7th generation's display is far from the better of the two. As a matter of fact, aside from size, the iPad Pro's display is better in just about every way. Let me explain. The iPad Pro's display features Display P3 support, which means it has a wider color gamut in comparison to the 7th generation iPads, adding support for more colors and a more vibrant display. The iPad Pro's display also has True Tone technology, which is a technology Apple created that allows the display's color balance to shift to warmer or cooler depending on the lighting environment you're in. So if you're working in a warm lighting environment, the display will become slightly more yellow, and in a cooler environment, slightly more blue. This means that your eyes are going to be less fatigued and makes the display great for extended use, especially if you're doing a lot of reading or even content watching late at night. As I said in my MacBook Pro review, True Tone is something that you really don't think you need, but once you get it, you kind of can't go back. The last difference is that the iPad Pro's display is fully laminated to the front glass. In addition, it also features an anti-glare coating. Now, both of these mean that the iPad Pro is much easier to use in brighter lighting conditions. In addition, it makes writing on the display with an Apple Pencil far more natural thanks to the lack of space between the glass and the display underneath. Moving on, because iPads are so frequently used for entertainment purposes, another important area to talk about is sound quality. And let's get one thing straight. As far as speaker quality goes between the iPads, there's really no comparison. The iPad Pro features a superior sound system that produces rich, immersive, and balanced audio thanks to four speakers located at the top and bottom of the device. In addition, the output of the sound will adjust depending on the orientation in which you're holding the iPad, ensuring that you get the highest quality audio experience you can. The 7th generation iPad features a still good set of two stereo speakers at the bottom end of the device, both of which are adjacent to the Lightning connector. That said, for obvious reasons, it's definitely not as good, and if you know you're going to be watching a lot of movies with no headphones, the iPad Pro is the way to go. The next major feature difference between the two iPads is camera quality. The iPad Pro features a 12 megapixel rear-facing camera with True Tone flash. It can also record in up to 4K at 30 frames per second. On the flip side, the iPad Pro has a 5 megapixel front camera that's capable of recording at 720p. The newer 7th generation iPad has a notably worse camera that is 8 megapixels, features no flash, and can record in only 1080p. And on the front side, it has a very low 1.2 megapixel camera that's also capable of recording 720p. Again, the difference here is obvious in that the iPad Pro is just far superior in comparison to the iPad 7th generation. That said, however much that means to you depends on you. I know personally, I don't spend too much time in the camera app on my iPad. I don't really know too many people that do either. But if you do, then you know which one to get. And if you don't, then that's another thing you don't have to worry about going forward. Now, the last thing I want to talk about when comparing the two is weight and thickness, as well as performance. Now, the reason why I save these for the end is because they're relatively minor when it comes to differences, and honestly, it's not very meaningful. The iPad Pro weighs 0.98 pounds compared to the 7th generation's 1.07 pounds. And it's a little thinner than the 7th generation at 6.1 millimeters thin compared to 7.5 millimeters thin. Now, the higher weight of the 7th generation is an obvious result of the slightly larger display. And it should be considered really only if you'll spend a lot and a lot of time reading on your iPad, because you might notice that extra weight. Either way, both devices are very thin and light and feature a very similar design that is made of an aluminum back case with a front display that has a 4:3 aspect ratio. Both also come in a variety of finishes that include gold, rose gold, silver, and space gray. Now, moving on to performance, I saved this for last because there's literally no comparison. Despite being years newer, which you would think makes the iPad 7th generation much faster, it actually uses a processor called the A10 that was launched all the way back in September of 2016, not long after the March 2016 release date of the iPad Pro 9.7. That means performance, even on benchmarks, is only marginally better. And when translating that to real-world use, it's pretty much indistinguishable. So you really shouldn't weigh that too heavily when making your purchasing decision. Now, if you're really looking for a higher performing iPad, the best thing you could do is look at the newest iPad Pros, the iPad Air, or the iPad Mini, all of which feature the A12 processor, which is the latest Apple processor that you can get in any of these tablets. As we wrap things up, I want to make one thing clear. If you're looking for a brand new tablet, the iPad 7th generation is one of, if not the best tablets you can get on the market for the money. But if you're open to buying pre-owned, the iPad Pro is simply a more compelling value. It offers a better experience for entertainment, studying, and creation alike, all thanks to its far and away better speakers, display, and camera systems. And its slightly smaller design might even make it the preferred option for heavy readers, which I would actually really recommend the iPad Mini for. But anyways, ultimately, whichever one you decide to buy depends on you, the viewer. And the reason I say that is because everybody has different needs, a different budget, and a different level of comfort when it comes to buying pre-owned, which you can't really argue with. Alright guys, that does it for today's video. Let me know down in the comments below which iPad you think is a better value for the money. Also, if you found this video useful, please share it, and if you liked it, please like it. If you didn't like it, you can dislike it. I won't take it personally, and if you want to see more, please subscribe.